Hello and welcome to the topic, what is hierarchical structure? The constituents, parts or elements of a complex thing are themselves complex. In other words, the parts themselves consist of parts, which may in turn consist of further parts. When this is so, we may speak of a hierarchy of parts and of hierarchical structure. So, hierarchical structure consists of parts or elements of something complex arranged in orderly form. We move on to the next. Let's have an example to understand hierarchical structure through parts of a bicycle. A bicycle can be analyzed into two wheels, a frame, a chain, handlebars, among other things. It must be kept in mind that the constituents of a complex thing can themselves be complex. An example of this is a bicycle wheel. The wheel is a constituent or part of the bicycle, but in turn the wheel consists of hub, spokes, rim, tire, valve, etc., as you can see in the picture. Thus we can say that hub, spokes, rim, tire, etc. are the constituents of a wheel. They are not the immediate constituents of a bicycle. Well, spokes are constituents of a bicycle, but they are constituents of bicycles only because they are constituents of the wheel, which in turn is a constituent of the bicycle. The relation between a spoke and bicycle is indirect, mediated by wheel. There is no direct connection between the bicycle and the spoke. The spokes don't have a function in respect of the bicycle directly, but only in respect of the wheels. Thus, we come to the point that specifying the function of constituents is an important part of a structure analysis. Which of the following tree diagrams best represents the structural relationship between bicycle and a spoke just discussed? Look at this picture. Bicycle, wheel, spoke, tube. Does it truly represent a tree diagram of the structural relationship between bicycle and a spoke? What about B? Bicycle. Then it has a further part, wheel. Then wheel is further having two parts, rim and a spoke. Definitely, the correct answer is B. The one that more accurately reflects the structural relationship between bicycle and a spoke is B. It says that spokes are constituents of wheels, which in turn constituents of bicycle. It correctly describes the relationship between bicycle, wheel and spoke, rim, as being a hierarchical relation. In language, or particularly in the study of syntactic structure, we follow three most important steps. What are they? First, we analyze linguistic expressions into their constituents. Second, we identify the categories of those constituents. And third, we determine their functions. What do sentences consist of? The obvious answer is words. But are words the immediate constituents of the sentences that contain them? The answer is no. In the way we have analyzed the structure of a bicycle, we will have to follow the same to analyze sentences through hierarchical structure. The reason is that sentences have structure forces. The very idea of hierarchical structure abandons the idea of sentences consisting of words. Let's draw a tree diagram of sentence. Old Sam sunbathed beside a stream. This is the tree diagram of this sentence. Old Sam sunbathed beside a stream. Is this tree diagram an accurate representation of the structure of the sentence? What do you think? Do you feel that this diagram is a true description of the sentence? Of course not. How much does it inform us about sentence? Well, it tells us what words appear in the sentence and in what order they appear, but nothing more. As well as being uninformative, this diagram is actually wrong as a description of the structure of the sentence. In essence, it says of sentence that it has no structure, or no more structure than a sequence of numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6, or an ordered string of beats. That's all. This is surely a wrong way to analyze a sentence hierarchically. We move on to the next. Now look at the structural analysis of the sentence. scientifically or syntactically. Old Sam sunbathed beside a stream. It can be further put into this constituent, Old Sam, and further Old Sam is divided into two, Old and Sam. Likewise, we have sunbathed, then we put sunbathe into a different constituent, and then D for the past tense, sunbathed. Likewise, we have beside a stream into a different constituent, and then further it is put into a different part, beside, and then I stream having a different phrase, then we can further have different part, A and stream. What do we get? We get that mere words are not immediate constituents of these sentences. The words in a sentence must work in groups. They must develop immediate relationship with each other. The words which form groups are known as phrases, and phrases have their own position in the structure of the sentence. In short, while sentences certainly contain words, they don't consist of words. They consist of phrases. Having recognized it as a phrase, we must treat its words as parts, not directly of the sentence, but of the phrase itself. This phrase is intermediate between the sentence and its words, just as wheels are intermediate between the bicycle and its spokes. So what we come to understand is hierarchical structure consists of parts or elements of something complex arranged in orderly form. Hope you understand the concept. Thank you and goodbye.